I'm really sorry. It just doesn't fit our model here at SHH. I mean, armed security mushrooms? Really? How do you expect that to work?
Commander Cadmium, you won't regret this. I mean, look at this mushroom. It has a little cop hat on. I mean, I'm intimidated.
Look, Fungi Fern, you got your start here at SHH, and I respect you. But my answer is no. Ah! Agents Aeon and Amethyst, come in! Fern was just leaving. Sit down, you two.
What is it, Commander?
Starting early today, I'm afraid. We have reports that the Hawthorne Hipsters on the outskirts of town making some kind of huge bonfire. It's raising quite a ruckus out there. Get on it, you two. Sure thing, Commander.
I don't get it. Why is the Commander so upset about a bonfire? I mean, sure, it's annoying, but why get us involved?
Don't you get it? Cadmium's worried about all the particulate matter being given off by the bonfire. You know, particulate matter? It's a mixture of tiny solid particles and liquid droplets found in the atmosphere. It can also be known as particle pollution.
So little particles get in the air, so what?
Well, sometimes the particles are just soil or dust, but other times organic chemicals and metals can become airborne. Consider this. The Hawthorne Hipster is burning something out there. When she lights the fire, smoke is given off. That smoke will contain tiny particles of whatever chemicals were in her fire.
So if the chemical is highly toxic,
then it's getting into the air.
Then we better get on it. Let's go. So how do all these particles get in the air anyway?
Well, human activities like construction, mining, processing metals or stones, or combustion can release particles.
Yeah, combustion, like bonfires. Or burning fuel to make your car run, no?
Yes, burning fossil fuels will release particles in the air. That's why the agency gives us these cars that run on kale. It's not just human activity, though. Pollen, sea salt, or dust can be blown around from just the wind. Or wildfires and volcanic activity can release massive amounts of particles in the air naturally.
Volcanic activity! Like that time with the giant chicken in the theme song!
Yeah, they never show the coolest parts from the theme song.
Overproduced big record label garbage.
Hey, Hawthorne Hipster, knock it off!
By the authority given to us by SHH, we order you to cease and desist. You're being a major source of pollution right now.
Really? How is this any worse than the noise pollution caused by Taylan Rift and her poppy mainstream sound? You should be thanking me.
Well, actually, we're more concerned with all the particulate matter you're releasing into the air. Those albums are covered in plastic, and all the chemicals in them and the wood are thrown into the air through that smoke.
So, I'm sending Taylan Rift's terrible music into the sky where it can't hurt anyone anymore.
See, that's where you're wrong, Hipster. All those chemicals going into the air can make people way more ill than country pop fusion music. Depending on the kind of particulate matter and the level of exposure, people who breathe in the smoke could have exaggerated respiratory symptoms, like coughing or difficult breathing, aggravated asthma, decreased lung functions, irregular heartbeat, non-fatal heart attacks, or premature death if that person has a heart or lung disease.
Clearly you've never heard these songs.
And this fire is particularly bad because of the plastic. Some particles are called primary particles. This matter is directly released from the source. This could include dust or ash that's coming from this fire.
What we're more concerned with right now are the secondary particles from your fire. Those chemicals in the plastic are forming secondary particles. These are particles that form from chemical reactions in the atmosphere. Secondary particles are the majority of particulate matter in the US and are commonly released by power plants and automobiles and you, Hawthorne Hipster.
You still don't get it, do you? I'm burdened with a glorious purpose. I'm freeing us from corporate trends.
Eh, she's not getting it.
Nope. We're going to need one of those blank backgrounds for educational things to happen on.
Oh, goody! I love those!
Yep, try it in.
This place reminds me of my soul.
Wait, are you hipster or emo? You've got to keep your writing consistent.
Okay, you two. Look, this is a human hair. To us, they seem very thin. But by particulate matter scale, it's pretty big. One human hair is about 50 to 70 micrometers in diameter. Here's a little piece of particulate matter. This could represent dust or pollen. It's about 10 micrometers in diameter. That's pretty tiny.
Dusty pollen? They sold out after their first album.
You're going to have a very rich career as a barista.
So, if that particle is only about 10 micrometers in diameter, that means we could stretch 5 of them across one human hair.
Exactly. Now, check this particle out.
Yeah, I can't see that at all.
It is pretty hard to see. This kind of particulate matter represents metals, organic compounds, or particles formed from combustion, like the chemicals coming out of your burning plastic.
So, how many micrometers is that one?
This is only 2.5 micrometers in diameter. That's so small that 4 of them could fit across the diameter of one of our 10 micrometer particles.
Well, if these particles are so tiny, why would they cause health problems? Shouldn't they just slip right through our bodies?
You might think that, but the particles ranging from 2.5 to 10 micrometers are the most dangerous types of particle pollution. In fact, particles that are 2.5 to 10 micrometers in diameter are what particulate pollution is defined as.
I would guess that's because the 10 micrometer particles, like pollen, are small enough to get in your lungs and aggravate allergies.
Yep. And the smallest particles are the most dangerous, because they're small enough to get into your blood vessels. That's when some major concerns can happen.
Hey, why is it foggy in here? Fog is so mainstream.
So, particulate pollution is not just a health concern. It also contributes to reduced visibility and haze.
What's that thing?
That's a carbon monoxide molecule. It's an incredibly tiny little molecule that can cause big problems.
When you burn plastics, fossil fuels, wood, run a car, or smoke tobacco, you produce carbon monoxide.
Well, it sounds like it's already everywhere. Sellout!
It is. Carbon monoxide is most commonly found in car exhaust, but it can also be found in homes' gas furnaces, chimneys, or malfunctioning appliances.
The bigger problem is what carbon monoxide does in your body. Since carbon monoxide is so small, it can get in your blood. Carbon monoxide happens to attach well to your red blood cells. This converts that chemical that carries oxygen in your blood, hemoglobin, and converts it into a chemical called carboxyhemoglobin.
I was listening to hemoglobin back when it was just globin.
You have to be making this stuff up, right?
Without hemoglobin to carry oxygen to your body, you may experience headaches, dizziness, fatigue, chest pain, difficulty breathing, memory loss, or flu-like symptoms in the short term. However, if you're exposed to too much of it, you can develop heart disease, damage your nervous system, go into a coma, or even die.
Okay, I have to admit that's kind of scary. I'll make sure my fire doesn't release any carbon monoxide.
That's the thing. Since carbon monoxide is colorless and odorless, you won't even notice it's around.
What? But how can I avoid it?
Well, to start, make sure to never leave your car running in the garage with the door shut. The carbon monoxide can build up.
Also, make sure to get your exhaust system regularly checked to prevent carbon monoxide leaks.
Hey, so your suspension looks to have leaked brake fluid all over the internal drive shaft, which has just completely corroded the flux capacitor. That's going to run you about $35,000. Well, that sounds like an honest assessment. Is this enough?
Securing your house is important, too. Never use portable flameless heaters in the house, or burn anything in an area that isn't vented. You can also install a carbon monoxide detector in your house to warn you of unsafe levels. Remember, it's just like a smoke alarm. It needs to have its batteries replaced regularly.
You can also make sure your fireplace is well vented and cleaned. Evening, Governor. You haven't seen a practically perfect lady come through here, have you? Not without violating a copyright. Cheers!
It's not just carbon monoxide either. Burnings can also release nitrogen oxides. These chemicals can come in contact with rain and become acid rain. Acid rain can change the chemistry of our environment and affect our health.
Or you could be releasing sulfur dioxide. It smells awful, and it makes you feel like you're suffocating. Not only is it gross, it can burn your skin and eyes or cause respiratory irritation.
And who knows what other effects the chemicals you're releasing could have.
All right. Time to put that fire out! Whoa! What's in the air here? I suddenly feel like, oh, I'm 15 and it's really hard and Dad's on the tractor and the boy doesn't like me. Why won't he go to the dance with me? I'm 15! 15's tough!
Ah, okay! I'll put it out!
I'm glad we could solve this situation without tempers. Larry.
I don't get paid enough for this.
Hey, come on! We We need to work on our witty agent banter. Now, gosh, hey, we need to make a quick stop before we get back to headquarters.
I keep telling you, that's not a farmer's market. It's a pet store.
Nah, not that. I forgot my ID. We have to go to my apartment.
Your apartment? As in, your apartment?
Relax, it'll be fine.
Look, I just remember the holiday party a few years back.
I took care of the badger. You'll see. It's no problem.
Well, this place is a reality show waiting to happen.
Hey, I don't judge you for that perm. 1993 called and wants its hairstyle back. Hello, Sprinkles. Hello, Mr. Giggles. Hello, Cuddy Fluffle Waffle. Hello, Dr. Cutesy Hugs, holder of PhD in Cuddles. Hello, Stripes the Tiger.
Okay, Stripes is definitely a raccoon.
No, you're a raccoon.
Just hurry up and find your ID.
Don't worry, it's right here underneath my dinner from Tuesday.
It's Friday!
Oh, and you've never had leftovers.
We seriously have to deal with a particular matter in here. This place is an absolute biohazard.
What do you mean? I'm not burning anything in here. How is there particulate matter?
Not all particulate matter is chemical. A huge amount of particulate matter comes from a biological or living origin.
Oh, sure, like pollen. I know all about that.
You do?
Yep, my allergies are crazy bad. Pollen is the male reproductive cell in a plant. Many trees release billions of pollen grains to fertilize other trees and form seeds. Pollen can be carried by insects or other pollinating animals between plants. This pollen is usually used by flowering plants. It doesn't create a lot of problems for humans. Other plants use the wind to carry pollen. Those plants are the problem. This pollen can aggravate symptoms of hay fever or asthma. This impacts about 25% of the population in the U.S.
Uh-oh. Let me help out here. Pollen counts in the air are highest in the early morning hours, between 5 and 10 a.m. Dry, windy, hot days are ideal times for pollen to be released. So watch out if you know this impacts you.
You see? That's why I don't have any plants in here.
Okay, but you still have some major particulate matter sources. Haven't you noticed all those green and white fuzzy patches all over your apartment?
Oh, you mean the snuggle patches on my walls?
Those aren't snuggle patches! They're mold, fungus, bad!
Ah, come on! How can fungus hurt anybody? The word fun's right in it.
Oh gosh, okay. Similar to plants, fungi have reproductive cells called spores. Like pollen, fungal spores can be carried by the wind, and insects, or even in water. In fact, fungal spores are more common in the atmosphere than pollen.
But can spores cause the same problems as pollen?
They sure can. Spores can cause allergen side effects like sneezing, runny nose, mucus production, cough, congestion, earache, headache, wheezing, asthma, or other illnesses like asthma.
Oh, great.
I'm not done yet. The worst bit is that fungi release chemicals called mycotoxins when they break down their food. These mycotoxins can also get on spores before they enter your body. In your body, mycotoxins can cause infections. Some of these mycotoxins can cause cancer, asthma-like illnesses, and some are even fatal.
Ah, okay, get rid of the mold! Get rid of the mold!
I'm not done yet. We still need to talk about those!
Ah, not my preciouses!
Not just the cats. It's also the nasty dust all over this place. Your dirty clothes? These sheets you probably haven't changed since YOLO was a thing.
What about them?
They're all encouraging dust mites.
Dust mites.
Here, look. Dust mites. These little guys are microscopic arachnids, the relatives of spiders and ticks. They feed on the flakes of skin that people and animals shed all the time.
Gross. Get a life, guys.
Well, we do need them. Otherwise, this stuff would just sit around, and we'd be waiting in dead skin. But we don't need to provide them with an international house of detritus, like you have. The remains dust mites leave behind is the main cause of dust allergies in people, and they're found everywhere. Mattresses, pillows, bed linens, carpets, draperies, upholstered furniture, even stuffed toys.
Okay, fungal spores and dust mites. This place is literally filled with particulate matter. How can I fix it?
Well, for the mites, we need to wash your stuff. You should be washing your sheets weekly in water above 130 degrees Fahrenheit to take care of the mites. Also, make sure that all of this dust is clean. Vacuum regularly to keep the dust and cat hair from collecting. For the spores, make sure you have all the areas of your apartment well ventilated to prevent moisture. I would also suggest that you maybe start wrapping your food and, like, use the fridge instead of the floor. However, we already have mold growing on the walls. We need to clean up this stuff with bleach. Like, 5 or 6 of these. Much better.
We better get back to headquarters quick. The commander's gonna be steamed. Hey, Steve.
Wait, Amethyst, this isn't... Hey, wait!
So then, we gotta stop burning the records because this guy was singing songs about how being a 15-year-old girl was so hard.
Hey, Amethyst, don't you notice something weird going on here? Ah! And what's with the commander?
Look, he's sensitive about that new hairpiece. Be nice.
That's not a wig!
Okay, now you're just trying to oversell it.
No, look, it's a mushroom!
You're right! Oh my gosh. This green haze must be spores! They're everywhere!
Okay, what are we going to do?
It looks like the spores are coming out of the vents. I'll go look for the source. You take care of the commander's office.
Deal. Whoa. These must be military grade.
Almost there. Must. Keep going.
Must.
Keep going.
Let's do this.
Ignore me, will he? Scoff at my ideas? Well, frankly, Commander Cadmium, I find you to be a spore.
How do I get out of this vent? Smooth.
The gig's up, Fungi Fern. Oh, Fungi Fern. Oh, like fungi. Oh my gosh, that makes so much sense now. It's too late, Amethyst. I've already taken over.
You were saying?
For protecting the super-hidden humans from the dangers of particulate matter, both chemical and organic, I promote you two to level 8 agents.
Now you get to know Phil's still alive.